Holy calamity, scream insanity. All you ever gonna be's another great fan of me.
tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear. Bottles of party rocking around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday.
Can't the future just wait? Can't the deadlines come fashionably late? I could push every goal back, take control back, if they'd roll back the rate at which time starts to fly. Never landing or standing by, never taking a break, ever making me retry. We nickel and dime every quarter to two. But maybe it's time to let time pass through. If the future is bright, it doesn't shine with that end of the tunnel light. More like a deer in the headlights, sudden red lights, or your deadlights as the anglerfish bite. It's not fair. The past is clear, but it's clear back there. What's ahead, no one knows. But it's closing in, we swear. Still not in my prime, I have so much to do. But maybe it's time to let time pass through. I can't just rewrite decisions when life gets strange. Should I go with my gut? On which door I should shut? I'm unsure, I'd keep exploring this rut. But what good is time without change? Things never last, just move on. Cause it goes too fast and the past has passed, so move on. No one likes an ending, so what's with the attention we keep on giving them? Why are we still spending so much time dreading our lives instead of living them? Why do we try to divert the river when the water is what will deliver us where we need to go? We may never know why. Time is always in limited supply, but we'll live to regret it if we get it and then let it slip by. It can never rewind. Once you've lost it, it's hard to find. Take the journey in stride when your plans have been sidelined. Every hourly chime could begin something new. So maybe it's time to let time pass through. Not passing by, but passing through. Till the well runs dry, just pass.
future husband, here's a few things you need to know if you wanna be my one and only all my life.
Take me on a date, I deserve a babe. And don't forget the flowers every anniversary. Cause if you treat me right, I'll be the perfect wife. Buying groceries, buying what you need. You got the 9 to 5, but baby, so do I. So don't be thinking I'll be home and making apple pies. I never learned to cook, but I can pride a hook. Sing along with me, sing along with me. Hey, you gotta know how to treat me like a lady. Even when I'm acting crazy, tell me everything's alright. Dear future husband, here's a few things you need to know.
Yeah, Jake, is the cam set?
Yeah, ready when you are.
Striking.
Is this boom pole supposed to have a mic on it, or what? Okay, everybody, get into positions.
Everyone clear. I've been rolling the whole time for B-roll. I'm gonna put the camera on the tripod first shot. Okay, ready? 2, 1, action.
Hey, horror buffs, I'm Brad.
And I'm Beth.
And this is Spectre Skeptics.
With my brains and his bravery,
we'll be debunking the claims that this school is haunted. As the story goes, years ago there was a conflict between rival Girl Scout troops. One thing led to another, and a Girl Scout was thrown off the balcony to her death. Now it's said that her soul still haunts the school grounds, tormenting students and staff alike. The janitor, the only staff member still working there, leaves a box of cookies once a month to satiate the ghost's hunger. My girlfriend eats these cookies.
What girlfriend?
She goes to a different school. She's real, I swear.
Uh-huh.
Well, team, It's exactly where the janitor said it would be.
What a silly practice. Whatever gets him to sleep at night, I guess. There is zero scientific evidence to support the idea that ghosts actually exist. My theory is that it's a series of coincidences people have connected in their minds.
So, we wanted to stir up some paranormal activity, so we respectfully took apart the shrine. Hey, ghost! Sit there! Okay, so now that the shrine has been respectfully dismantled, I thought that something was gonna happen immediately, but I guess not.
Most ghost sightings are just hallucinations or confirmation bias. Let me finish. Most people that claim to see a ghost really just were expecting to see a ghost. So any strange thing they see out of the corner of their eye suddenly becomes a ghost.
Guys, there's a ghost behind you.
Are you sure about that?
Listen, Grace, I don't want to invalidate any of your experiences, but there's nothing there. If you're... It's your first shoot, so I'm not gonna fault you for paranoia, but if you're gonna make assertions like that, at least be right about them. Otherwise,
both of these supposed ghost sightings are most likely just caused by light refracting through the fog.
No. I've seen light in fog. That did not look like light shining through fog.
I think this is a good spot. I like the lighting.
There's no lore in this area. What are we supposed to talk about anyway?
Don't worry, I'll come up with something. You rolling?
Whole time.
Grace, you rolling sound?
There's no mic.
Okay, right now we're in the lunch area, and this is where the ghost sold cookies and where the conflict between Girl Scout troops began. There should be lots of negative energy and malice in the area.
Of course negative energy doesn't actually exist.
This patio is the same as any other, just a little dustier.
And here we have it. The place where the ghost sold her last box of cookies.
Aww, but it's such a shame that she died so young.
Okay.
If anyone was a alternative of ghosts, it'd be her. Of course she isn't, because it isn't possible.
What was that?
Brad, something just popped up behind you.
What, another ghost?
It says, "You lie, get out." I wonder who that's for. We could fix that in post.
No, I won't.
So right now, we're looking for negative energy and malice in the area. We can start off with this trash can. See this trash can? Yeah, it definitely smells.
Yeah, I smell that too. Wait, I think it's... Oh, it's you.
It's not my fault I haven't showered in 2 weeks, okay?
That's kind of your fault.
Anyways, caution tape, police has already been here. They know what's good, not ghost.
Good joke.
Wow, that was really good.
Okay. Let's keep on moving. There's more ghost area down the hallway.
I ran out of ideas for where else to go, so we started exploring.
Hey, ghost! Your cookies kinda suck!
Is that necessary?
Well, this ghost is clearly a coward and hasn't done anything all night.
Guys, can we take a break? I'm not feeling great.
Actually, we need to pause. I have to change batteries.
All right, we'll take 5, I guess.
Of course we're gonna see a ghost.
No, I hope so.
Hey guys, look what I brought. I was saying this was the end, but I'm hungry as hell.
They're cookies. What's so special?
This little rival cookie?
No!
Run. Okay, so I feel like we've done enough,
Yeah.
We planned for 3 other locations. I don't want to come back.
I gotta take a piss.
Yeah, same.
Holy Brad, Bert! Guys, this is fake.
Think. How do I fix this? Oh my god! Ah.
Yeah, needless to say, I'm no longer a skeptic.
Here I stand, looking like a tall glass of drink, blind to the atrocities I would see in just a few moments.
Significant other, I'm home! No!
It always ends out like this. It started off with the bullying. They'd always stand in front of me, holding two objects, asking which one is blue and which is red. I would always pick the left one. It would turn out not even to be an object, but a sheet of paper. And then they would die, inextricably, just so that I would have to pick up the clues. Taking control of my emotions, I checked the body for clues. One day, I might finally find the fateful mistake that would lead me to my significant other's killer, a feat that none other than I could accomplish, for their killer would be an intelligent one, to be able to get the better of them. Yes, it would be I. Oh. I quickly take action and call my friend in the police department to inform him of the results of my investigation.
Hello?
Even though we were separated from two lengths of an invisible barrier, I could still smell the whiskers from his own beard as if we were talking from within the same four walls.
Are you done?
Yes, yeah.
So looks like we already found the culprit. Jacob Donahue confessed to the murder.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's great.
But wait, it's too easy. Such a frugal conclusion would never come by for a murder such as this.
Oh, actually, it looks like it was a cover-up. Yeah, Jacob said he was paid thousands to plant fingerprints on the scene and confess to the murder.
Oh, so you already,
Yeah, we figured it all out. No need to come in.
At this point, I was beginning to become suspicious. Could my good friend, detective friend, whom I'd known for at least a couple weeks, be trying to double-cross me? Wait a second.
You're perceptive, Noir. Too perceptive for your own good. See, we knew we'd have to create an elaborate plan to throw you off, so we paid someone else to take the fall. We staged the body to have his fingerprints and hair everywhere, just so that you would find them and call me.
But why would you want me to call you?
Too perceptive, Noir. I shouldn't have expected less from a person of your stature. It's true, the person I actually paid was your significant other, because I really wanted to do dead body cosplay. Jacob Donahue was only a mistake to cover up.
This is all making sense. If that's the case, there's no murder, right? Problem solved.
No, Noir. Problem not solved. There's still one last thing we need to figure out. Tell me. Which one of these is red, and which one is blue?
No!
It all started when I was young, you know.
I tripped and I fell in the playground, and my ma, bless her heart, she didn't even see, and I laid there and I felt so dead. That's when it really started. I couldn't help myself. I just loved being a dead body. That's why I became a detective, so I could really perfect my craft. I ain't ever told anybody about this, but brings a tear to my eye every brings a tear to my eye every single time I see one of those corpses. I think, God, I wish that was me. I wish it was me. So this is what I do now. I pay him off. I get my kicks, but it's never enough. One of these days, I'll be a real dead body, and maybe some young, green, new detective will come in and find their passion within my corpse. That's my dream.
It's time!
Yes, yes. They told me it couldn't be done. My concoction, it's finally here.
Ne me quitte pas, il faut oublier, tout peut s'oublier, qui s'enfuit déjà, oublier le temps des malentendus et le temps perdu, à savoir comment oublier ces heures qui tuaient parfois à coup de pourquoi le cœur du bonheur. Ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Moi, je t'offrirai des perles de pluie venues de pays où il ne pleut pas. Je creuserai la terre jusqu'après ma mort pour couvrir ton corps d'or et de lumière. Je ferai un domaine où l'amour sera roi, où l'amour sera loi, où tu seras reine. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, je t'inventerai des mots insensés que tu comprendras Je te parlerai de ces amants-là qui ont vu deux fois leur cœur s'embraser. Je te raconterai l'histoire de ce roi mort de n'avoir pas pu te rencontrer. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. On a vu souvent rejaillir le feu de l'ancien volcan qu'on croyait trop vieux. Il est, paraît-il, des terres brûlées donnant plus de blé qu'un meilleur avril. Et quand vient le soir pour qu'un ciel flamboie, le rouge et le noir ne s'épousent-ils pas? Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, je ne vais plus pleurer, je ne vais plus parler, je me cacherai là, à te regarder danser et sourire, et à t'écouter chanter, et puis rire. Laisse-moi devenir l'ombre de ton ombre, l'ombre de ta main, l'ombre de ton chien. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas.
Welcome to the behind the scenes and all that jazz. Anyways, I guess you can come with me. JU will come soon, and the set will be built probably around these just two black walls right here and be set like this. I guess the only thing we're doing right now is just waiting for JD.
So, do you mind if we leave really quick?
Okay. I guess on our quest right now, let's go find JD then.
Damn, what should I do?
For what? I don't see anything.
This whole gray area right here.
Mm-hmm. You pull it up. Oh, like this.
Is the cellular device?
Yeah.
Another deep one.
Hold on.
If the calling always helps you to
Thank you.
why can't I walk down a street? Free suggestion. Why can't I walk down a street? Free suggestion. Is my body my only trait? In the eyes of men. In the eyes of men! What got so scared?
They did this thing. Sid, you were talking about it.
So like halfway through this one song, they plug in the bass mm-hmm. and it sounds so good. Just like
yes.
vibrant, magnetic. Yeah, I really like that.
We should steal it.
Okay.
Yes. We should steal it. We should do the thing that we're working on. And I think that there's, we can do it at practice and just, you know, see if we like it, like recorded or something. And we can see there's enough time between that and the show for it to like, for us to see if it works, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, can I see?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yes. Oh, these are so amazing, but, I mean, how do we know anyone is actually going to see these?
I did get an A on it in my graphic design class.
I know, but so did you on your last one, and the one before that, and the one before that.
Okay,
and...
well.
I have a good feeling about this one.
Okay, but, should we post it more on social media?
With
or,
what? Our 200 followers combined on Instagram?
Okay, I guess you're right.
When we're famous, we're not gonna need flyers. They'll be like moths to the flame.
Mm. But who's the moth and who's the flame?
Oh, ha ha.
By the way, does anybody want food?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah? Okay.
I don't really know.
that song was dope. Do you guys have anything out?
Oh, thanks, man. We actually don't have anything out right now, but we do gigs like this every weekend, so.
Sick.
Yeah.
I'm Derek. Who are you guys?
I'm Cameron.
This is Beth.
This is Sid. And right now we go by Julia's Last Words. Yeah, but that is subject to change, so.
Right on. Yeah. Well, if you ever need help recording something, I've got a pretty sick studio and, you know, always looking for new groups to put it to use.
Are you kidding? We've been trying to find somewhere to record for forever.
How about Saturday at 3?
Yeah, that would be awesome, yeah.
Alright, sweet. Should I get you guys' numbers or?
Yeah, for sure.
You can just like use Instagram. It's just Julia's Last Words band name.
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. Alright, see you then.
Alright. See you then, dude. Guys,
what just happened?
Moss to flame, ladies, moss to flame.
Domain. Yeah, this is where the magic happens, or should I say where the music happens? You like that? That one was straight off the dome.
It's nice. It's, homey.
Yeah, well, Dreamsicle sure thought it was when they recorded here last week.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
We are totally obsessed with them.
Well, they're alright. I could put in a good word for you to get some tickets to their show next weekend.
Yeah, that would actually be really, really cool, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, yeah.
Careful with that, okay?
Hey, so when are we gonna start recording?
I was thinking maybe we'd lay down the vibe a little first, you know, get our energy pumping, get those creative juices flowing, and then we can set it in stone.
Yeah, well, I think you already have the song pretty much ready to go.
Sure, but we can chill for a little bit, yeah?
Yeah. It's a pretty sick P bass you got. You know what year it is?
Oh, yeah, not sure, actually. It was my brother's.
Yeah, that figures. I think that was the one. Let's, do a quick break. We'll come back after, you know, try one more just to be safe, and then I think we can call it a day.
Hey, groovy.
Yeah, that was awesome. Oh, by the way, Derek, where is your bathroom?
Oh, yeah. Straight through there, first door on the right. Can't miss it.
Okay, awesome. Thank you.
I'm gonna go get some snacks from the kitchen. Do you want a drink or a snack or anything?
No, thanks.
No drinks, nothing? No?
No, we're good.
Okay. Oh, hey. How long have you been playing bass for?
Oh, just about 3 years. Since I was a freshman, I'm pretty sure.
I thought you were older. Well, you sound pretty good to me.
Thanks.
I'm so glad that we did this, and I'm also so happy that we're all
Hey, can we pack it up pretty quick?
Yeah.
Of course, what's wrong?
I'm
tired.
Alright, let's just get this last take, unless it's your bedtime already.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's just finish this.
Oh my god!
gosh, guys, how cool is that? He's gonna put us in a show with Dreamsicle. We've been trying to see them for months.
I know, right? Plus, we killed that.
And then, yeah.
Hey, Sis. Sid!
Oh, yeah?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay. Oh, by the way, what was that all about when you came back from the restroom? Did something happen?
Oh, that. Yeah, everything's fine. Nothing happened. I don't even remember what happened.
Are you sure? You know you can tell us anything, right?
Yeah.
We're best friends for life!
Right.
yeah, I know.
Okay. Well, if you think of anything, just let us know, okay?
Like, I just love that part so much. They're all just like in the garden, just like as a powerful sister group, yeah. And they're all just bonding, and Lance just got them these new shoes. And of course, Barbie has to be stuck with the pink, because Barbie's the main character. I feel like she would be better in like a periwinkle or...
No, it's just Naomi.
God, Derek still hasn't texted me back about the mix or the show next week.
I'm sure he's just busy. He seemed to have a lot going on.
That's the thing. He didn't, like, at all. I mean, he had so much... nothing going on that he had time to help us. I don't know what we did to make him flake out like this. He seemed to really care, you know?
Well, did anybody say anything to piss him off?
Wait. Sid, you never really told us what happened after you came back from the bathroom the other day. Was it really nothing?
Yeah, I told you guys nothing happened. I'm sure he's just busy.
I'm sorry, Sid, but I actually have a hard time believing that. What else could it be? He's left me on red so many times, ignored all my calls. It doesn't seem like he's just busy to me.
Okay, well, I'm sorry that you guys don't believe me.
I gotta go.
Wait, don't go. You shouldn't have
to
go.
Bye, guys.
Still sound pretty good to me.
Oh.
You know, I could teach you a thing or two if you wanted to hang out sometime.
Wait, do you think she's all right?
I don't know. Guess we'll find out. Sid, I am so sorry about what happened the other day. I totally blew up on you, and I shouldn't have. You didn't do anything wrong.
No, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have stormed off. That's not entirely true, either. I was lying. What happened with me and Derek wasn't really nothing. So, he asked how long I played bass for, and he told him how old I was, and...
You know, if you ever wanted to hang out, I could teach you a thing or two.
What the hell, man?
I was just saying we could hang out. It's like not a big deal or anything.
Ah!
Your band sucks anyways.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, nothing really happened, but it was scary.
I'm so sorry, Sid. We had no idea.
Being a total jerk.
Wait, really? I thought you guys would be pissed.
No! No, you were standing up for yourself. I'm proud of you, Sid.
Yeah, you totally mortified him.
Besides, we could never be mad at you. You're our sister.
Guys!
Here we go.
They sound great for women.